LGBTQ is an acronym that stands for lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, and queer. You may know nothing about it. You may hear about it long time ago, or you're involved with this community. But do you know how East Asian newcomers think about LGBTQ community?
Hello, 我叫彭燕琴，今年16岁，来自中国。我是去年的9月份来的，现在是 Thornlea Secondary School 的一名在校生，在读10年级。
大家好，我叫王林杰，英文名叫 Linda， 我来自中国上海，这是我来加拿大的第3年。
I'm Chuck, I go by she. I'm from 广东。I speak Mandarin, Cantonese, and English. I work as an assistant in an immigrant counseling office.
Actually, there are many differences. First, the first thing I think is that people here are relatively比国内的要相对要开放一些，包括他们讨论事情。还有特别的一点，就在学校里面，老师不会去限制学生一些什么。
我觉得感觉很不一样的就是在国内的时候就没有那么多的男生朋友，因为每次只要一跟男生朋友玩得好，就是关系比较 close 以后，老师啊家长啊就会找你麻烦，就会说啊你们两个关系不大正常，就会以为可能你们要早恋啊还是怎么样。但是来了加拿大以后会发现，就是男女生相处，包括一些很多外国朋友，男女生相处是非常自然的。
The language you speak and then the process people are doing things and then also the way you perceive all the stuff, like the way you're learning, the way you talk to people, everything is different.
我觉得这里的生活节奏很慢，然后大家都比较友善，而且比较遵守秩序，空气还有环境也比较好。
其实刚来的那几个月我是处在一种焦虑的状态，因为首先语言环境是一个很大的问题，然后其次的话对这里的生活适应，包括水土啊，还有就是和学校同学的融合。首先是有的时候可能我并不是特别清楚他们要表达什么，其次我并不是特别知道自己要怎样表达自己的想法。
主要就是文化差异比较大吧，我还有天气原因，我还适应了挺长的一段时间。然后文化上的差异，就比如说因为我是来自中国南方的嘛，然后南方人说话就比较的委婉，但是来了国外以后我会发现大家就是想说什么就说出来，就不会跟你绕圈拐弯抹角这样说话。
Still there's like differences when compared with when you're using the language on a daily basis and then also it's just different from when you're preparing for a test.
第一还是语言，然后有一些这边的规矩，比如说坐streetcar 的时候需要拉一下那个 handle 然后才能下车站。
在我的周围其实是有 LGBTQ 的人群的，所以我觉得我对他们保持的态度就是接受的状态，就是我不会说特别排斥他。
我在国内的时候对 LGBTQ 并没有非常大的了解，而且我觉得国内的趋势就是比较歧视这一类的人。
I don't think there are too many spaces or like safe environment for the LGBTQ people to talk about their queerness. Also because of the like the social pressure, I wasn't out to any of the other relatives.I have a couple of like also like lesbian gay friends, but then that was still a small circle because the society wasn't really accepting that.
其实这个没有你想的那么可怕，就是最主要还是要更了解自己，然后 更了解这个族群是什么样子的存在。
其实如果对于我而言的话，在我的国家LGBTQ 其实可能会被视为一点点的另类，就是人们可能也会对这一类人群存在普遍的歧视。
在国内 LGBTQ 是被歧视的，他们没有受到社会平等的对待，所以说他们并没有很好的能面对自己这个性取向的问题，所以说并不是很对自己的这段感情比较 表示自信。
I would say the group of people they kind of we kind of living in a gray area, because we do have our community, but then like the official, the government don't really open about that, they don't really talk about it。
在我的国家我没有看到或者是参与什么这种组织，但是我觉得整个社会对这方面的接受度还不是很高。
如果像在加拿大的话，我觉得是比较开放的，比较民主的，人们对这类人群就是普遍是持以接受的状态，并不会用异样的眼光去看待他们。还有就是甚至在我们学校都有 LGBTQ 的 club， 我觉得这一点是很好的。
来了加拿大以后发现身边有很多就 LGBTQ 的人群，然后我觉得他们在加拿大是接受到平等对待，但 我见到的是接受到平等对待，但我不确定他们是不是在所有人眼里都接受到了平等对待。
Canada is like they're more advancedin sex education, so the kids are taught like what is LGBTQ, so they have a more clear perspective of sex education and also the current stuff.
在这边大家多多少少还是会更接受一些，所以这样的组织还有社团也会更多一些。我有一些朋友他们有参加这种社团，然后我看他们就是相处还蛮融洽的，而且还蛮开心的。
我强烈的呼吁大家能够平等的对待 LGBTQ 人群，还有新来加拿大的学生。
我强烈建议大家在尊重 LGBTQ 人群的同时，也要呼吁身边的人去尊重 LGBTQ， 并且平等的对待他们。
So I have this experience with some Chinese person that came to Canada. So they are kind of homophobic. The thing is, like, when we first start to meet each other, we have a lot of things in common, and then we are like chatting really happily. But then when they get to know that I'm lesbian, they kind of cut me off, like stop talking to me, and then pretend that we're strangers. So which has been triggered me a little bit. I feel like the queer people actually don't have any differences as the heterosexual people. I think everyone should be more open-minded, not only about the sexual orientation, but also about the diversity, about all the people that has differences as you.
虽然有很多人听说过，也在网上看到过一些这方面的消息，但是大多数人还是不够了解。我希望大家更多的人可以更关注并且接受